We don't need to get into the bright details to uncover this fact. Fluorescent colors look amazing. Whether you're looking at a Dayglo poster under blacklight or reviewing a reference, you can't help but wonder what makes these colors stand out from the rest. Today we're digging into what makes them pop, and we're going to highlight some of the brilliant applications of fluorescence coming out of nanotechnology. Now about that highlighter. High, light, it makes sense. Under the sun it looks bright, but under a black light it looks out of this world. Inside the seemingly magical yellow ink you'll find a vibrant compound called pyrenine. To understand how this stuff gets its brilliant glow, let's see why colors pop in the first place. This right here is the electromagnetic spectrum, a chart that shows us the different wavelengths of photonic radiation out there. Now, right in between ultraviolet and infrared radiation rests the visible light spectrum, a literal rainbow of frequencies that our human eyes can see. When light hits an object, the different wavelengths essentially do one of three things, depending on the structure of the chemicals making up that object. One, they get sucked up by the chemicals, that's absorption. Two, they bounce off the chemicals, that's reflection. Or three, they pass through, that's transmission. The reflected colors are what have a chance to make it to your eye, so they make up the object's color. Fluorescence is a trippy happening related to absorption that can give you access to colors normally outside the visible spectrum. When you see something fluoresce, you're kind of seeing a secret world beyond normal vision. Chemicals like a yellow highlighter's pyrenine have structures that absorb light from the ultraviolet range of the spectrum, wavelengths that our eyes cannot see. When these molecules absorb this funky light, they become excited into a higher state of energy and release most of this extra energy in the form of visible light, while the rest is released as heat. This means the objects are giving back more energy than they received from the visible light source, which explains their gleaming vibrancy under UV. And you may have noticed already that black lights only illuminate objects if they're fluorescent. Another surprisingly fluorescent liquid is tonic water. This otherwise clear liquid contains a compound called quinine that's derived from cinchona tree bark. This stuff fluoresces super bright under blacklight, illuminating gin lovers' glasses everywhere. But there's far more to fluorescence than unicorn posters. As with all interesting material properties, chemists have set their sights on fluorescence and come up with some brilliant applications. For example, fluorescence is expanding our understanding of microbiology. The newly discovered fluorescence of nanodiamonds have given researchers the ability to study how they interact and move through cells at much higher resolutions. This might help lead to better, safer nanomaterials in the future. Not to mention the use of fluorescent quantum dots, a bright light nanomaterial found in some newer TV screens. These nanoscopic crystals are allowing us to take a closer look at the structures of cells and can even identify and mark cancer cells while avoiding healthy ones. Speaking of biology, forensic crime scene investigators use fluorescence too. Not only do certain bodily fluids like saliva fluoresce, blood absorbs UV so splattered spots appear black, not red, under blacklight. Also for catastrophic car accidents, antifreeze is used as a fluorescent marker that helps investigators understand how an accident occurred. We want to give a big thanks to our friends over at the NSF Center for Sustainable Nanotechnology for helping us bring this video to life. For more nanoscience goodness, head over to their blog, there's a link down in the description, and while you're at it, check out this extra life hack video on how to make white flowers turn fluorescent. Make sure to hit thumbs up and subscribe on the way out, but before that, post that chemistry question of yours in the comments, and we'll see you again very soon.